here at Riverfront Park in Peekskill, and the wind is blowing, people are sailing, parasailing, and it's just a wonderful en plein air setting. Chris, what you selected this site, what went into your decision to look for this as a nice canvas for a plein air painting?
Well, when I see a location that has potential, I generally walk the area a little bit, look for the most interesting scene that I can find in it, and what appeals to me in this particular scene behind me, which is I'll be painting in this painting, is I've got some boats in the background, I've got some nice lights on those boats, I've got warm shadows on their side, I've got some haze in the background for the hills, I've got some beautiful rich greens in the foreground, I got a nice deep rich dark in the foreground here on the rocks that will give me some good contrast, and the overall shapes will lend itself to a good composition.
How do we start? You're gonna...
Well, I generally sketch in the major shapes in the scene to establish a composition. And then I lay out the major color and value relationships in the painting and sort of start to control the whole compositional element of the painting, and then I start to refine it from there.
Nice place to pause, and in this first phase of the painting, you're giving a consideration of colors and shapes. What is your first goal here in the first phase of this?
Well, the first thing that I'm trying to do is to establish the relationships that I find in the scene among the basic colors that are there, the larger shapes. And once they've been established, then I can begin to look into those shapes and find the smaller shapes that also are relating to each other and so forth until we refine the painting down to where I can feel I've accomplished everything that I'm looking for in this piece of work.
Mm-hmm. So is that your idea of your thinking of designing the scene, designing the painting? Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, the shapes that are there are sort of a stimulus for ideas. I'm not trying to capture exactly what I see there. I'm trying to refine them, exaggerate them, do something that might make them more dynamic or less dynamic, depending on what I want that area to feel like in the painting. So that's the challenge in painting, and it has to do with creating a more appealing and interesting composition.
All right, so we're here in Chris's studio with many examples of some of the plein air paintings he's done over the past few years, and we have different considerations here. And so let's take a look at this one, Chris. You'd said that the goal of the plein air painter is to get the quality, the value of the light and the color, and that the actual subject is not as important. Can you tell me a little bit why you're attracted to this scene?
Well, for me, I've been from a very early age attracted to back streets and urban areas for some reason that I cannot explain, because I didn't grow up in those areas, but they're in part of every city, and when I've traveled through them, I've always been impressed with the fact that there's no facade there. It's something about the simplicity of people's lives, and it's seen in the buildings and structures that they inhabit and work in and so forth. And as a painter, I'm also attracted to the shapes of light and so forth that fall in these structures.
So a plein air painter is like the postman, not snow, not sleet, not whatever will keep us from what we have to do. And is there a specific story behind this?
That's pretty much true, except we don't get a pension when we retire. But this painting was painted in weather that was near my limit. So this was 5 degrees above zero, and I have a winter outfit. I'm very bundled up. A very small portion of my face is exposed to the elements. But I actually enjoy painting in the wintertime with those kinds of conditions. There's something very peaceful about that environment, partly because I'm the only one out in it. Mm-hmm. But the light is particularly interesting in the wintertime, and there's great opportunities for paintings in the winter.
this seems like a suitable place to pause as our canvas is taking shape. And it might be a good time to speak a little bit about the en plein air movement and what they were, what en plein air painters do. The movement was begun to some extent in France with artists such as Monet and Renoir. And there are some people who get Van Gogh confused as an en plein air painter, but why wasn't he considered among that group?
Well, Van Gogh did paint on location, but his interest was the soul of the subject as opposed to the light that he found there. And the true impressionists were capturing the light as it fell across the subject, and they were pursuing that as their main interest. Van Gogh's pursuits went beyond that, and he's not truly a member of that group.
So we're interested in the interplay of color and light, and what can we see here? We're starting to see this again take shape. You built out this a little bit, you were telling me before.
Well, I've now gone back and I'm making more refinements to the basic colored shapes that I've established.
And there's also the abstract quality where you're bringing out, as we spoke about, you're creating a mood, you're really enhancing the mood of the scene for the viewer.
Well, as a painter, you're involved with the abstract qualities of the painting as much or more than you may be involved with the subject itself. Well, a painting is a reliable source of the feeling that you experienced when you first encountered it. So if you have a favorite artist or painting or period of painters, it's a comfort to know you can go to the museum and experience that same wonderful feeling that you get when you see that painting over and over again.